Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the induction ceremony for the West Virginia Golden Horseshoe Awards 2021. My name is Dustin Lambert, and I serve as the Social Studies Coordinator at the West Virginia Department of Education. I'll begin by asking that all cell phones and electronic devices be turned to silence. We would like to extend hearty greetings to Superintendent Birch. I believe we have Dr. Jan Barth with us, who is also the Assistant Superintendent of Schools. We have Delegate Sean Hornbuckle with us here today. West Virginia Supreme Court Justice Tim Armstead. And Sonia White, who is the Senior Officer in the Division of Teaching and Learning. We're thankful to see each of you today in person as we celebrate here at the West Virginia Culture Center. Yesterday, we were able to knight our 2020 winners of the Golden Horseshoe, and now today, we celebrate the 2021 Golden Horseshoe winners and honorees. We all share one common bond here today. We're all proud West Virginians, and we carry that fierce pride with dignity, honor, and with a great deal of respect. This is a day to celebrate being a West Virginian, but more so, it's a great day just to celebrate being an American. One very special person with us here today would like to take a moment to personally welcome and congratulate everyone. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to introduce to you the State Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Clayton Birch.
I asked the young lady there in the front if she'd like to do my speech, and she said no, she really doesn't want to do it. She'd rather just get the knighting. I'll remember that when we're playing with the sword. Good morning. As Dustin said, 10 ceremonies were held yesterday for the 2020 winners, which was interesting because since 1931, that would be the first time that the Golden Horseshoe ceremony was ever bestowed upon a group of incoming sophomores. And we all know why. Folks, you see here on the young people, I guess. I want to call you young women and men. I'm looking at the group. What they've been able to do during the course of this year and everything they've had to endure is quite amazing. They represent exactly what we mean when we say children are resilient and persevere. They have. Only 15,000 students since 1931 have received this award, and you're about ready to join those since 1931. 90 years, West Virginia has recognized the Golden Horseshoe winners. It's very, very special. But I think what makes this group even more special is they represent a lot of firsts. When I was in eighth grade, if I would have told my social studies teacher the crazy tale of what you had to endure in 2020, she would have told me, you might want to write that down. That will be one great science fiction story. In 1985, if I would have wrote this story and told a group of folks that in the future, we will have a group of children who will go to school with the threat of being quarantined, that are going to wear masks, that are going to stay up possibly on Saturday nights to wait for some crazy color-coded map to come out of whether or not they go to school or not, have to make choices of whether or not they're even going to be in person, go virtual, in and out of school. I'm telling you, my social studies teachers say you have a number one bestseller on your hands, go write. And you did it. Each and every one of you have done that throughout the year, and you're still here. You still represent the best we have in West Virginia. And today is about you. But I want to make sure we're very, very clear that today is also about those that are with us in the audience. You see, I have four children of my own, and I think sometimes that maybe I ought to head on over to the school and thank them for taking them back. I'm not sure which the pandemic was harder on them or us. So, most of you, if you've watched any of my videos and the things that we produce, we've talked about one caring adult. And I think the folks in this room represent not only just one caring adult you have in your lives, but hopefully what we've come to realize during the pandemic is the power, the absolute power teachers have in the lives of our children. What we saw we lost during this time, the number one thing was that connection our children have with our teachers. For the students who couldn't be in person, had trouble participating virtually, we noticed very, very quickly that if any time in the history of education, we do not know how powerful a teacher is in the lives of our children, it should be now. On behalf of the Board of Education, the Department of Education, we absolutely congratulate each and every one of you. Each and every year, we do congratulate the Golden Horseshoe winners, but I think this year, the 2021 inductees are going to be very, very special. With that, I do believe we have a brief message from Governor Justice, and then we'll turn it back over to Dustin Lambert and our readers to begin the ceremony. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I'm Governor Jim Justice. And what an incredible, incredible honor that's been bestowed upon me to be able to talk to you about an achievement. An achievement that's unbelievable. You know, every year since 1931, we have recognized those that have taken the Golden Horseshoe test. We've administered it since that time, and with all that, after we have received the ones that did pass the test and everything, we have absolutely either made them knights or ladies of the Golden Horseshoe. You know, if you just think about it, whether it be the state insect or it be, you know, the naming of Mother's Day or it be all the rich history of this incredible state, these young people have mastered all the things about the incredible history of West Virginia. And I challenge them all, as they go through their life, as they go through their life doing great things in communities or building careers or all the things that they do, I challenge each and every one of them to come up with some way, somehow, to stay here in this great state and absolutely invest in their communities and make this great state even richer in every way. So I congratulate all those that absolutely invested the time to know all the greatness about this incredible state. And in going forward, please, I ask you all to continue to invest that time. Invest that time to continue to obtain more knowledge, to make our communities richer, to make all of our lives richer in West Virginia. Thank you so much. Congratulations again from the bottom of my heart.
Thank you, Governor Jim Justice. Thank you, Superintendent Birch, for those remarks. As we prepare for the knighting ceremony, I would like to give some general directions about how we'll proceed. Superintendent Birch will have the honor of knighting our Golden Horseshoe recipients, along with our special guest for the pinning. We have an official photographer who will be taking photos of each knight and lady of the Golden Horseshoe. Each student will receive an individual photo of their individual knighting, courtesy of the West Virginia Department of Education. Please do not move about the theater to take photos or videos during the proceedings, as you may be blocking the view of others in the audience. Please hold all applause for the student inductees until after the ceremony has been completed. Please do not use flash photography during the knighting, as this affects our photographers' camera settings. To the Golden Horseshoe candidates, you will be called in alphabetical order by county. As your name is called, please come forward to the front of the stage, face Superintendent Birch, and he will then dub you a knight of the Golden Horseshoe. If you are wearing a mask, we do ask that you remove the mask during the knighting and the photo. Once knighted, you will then proceed across the stage and receive your official Golden Horseshoe pin. You may then return to your seat. It is tradition for us to open the ceremony with a trumpet fanfare performed by students from George Washington High School under the direction of Mark Hardman. Mr. Hardman wrote this fanfare especially for the Golden Horseshoe ceremony. He is an outstanding educator, and we are so proud of these George Washington High School trumpeters. At this time, The trumpet fanfare will be signaling the start of the knighting ceremony of the West Virginia Golden Horseshoe. I would like to ask our first group of students to now stand and proceed to the lower stage. Our readers, Mrs. Gloria Burdett and Dr. Andrea Lemon, will now announce the winners.
Boone County, Amaya Aboitez. Jeslyn Moore. Braxton County, Laura Kane. Emily Garrett. Owen McAllister. Cabell County, Audrey Barrios. Winnie Bird. Juliet Bond. Tristan Hornbuckle. Eli Morris. Natalie Simpkins. Calhoun County, Catherine Carper. Kendra Davis. Gracie Champ. Kaylee Hamrick. Gunner Lane. Harrison County. Owen Beto. Seth Gain. Henry Kennedy. Wyatt LeFevre. Hayden Lewis. Peyton Scott. Chas Wisner. Jeremiah Franklin. Mason Lanham. Rebecca Weekly. Kanawha County. Ewan Becker. Ty Lee Boone. Sean Eggleston. Raven Fowler. Zachary Harrison. Aurelia Kirby. Mia Crompetcher. Devin Rader. William Salutilio. John Settle. Dennis Wang.
Lewis County. Brenly Wilson. Parker Williams. Lincoln County, Logan Glenn. Nicholas Lenville. Noah Lenville. Bobby Lucas. Logan County, Andrew Browning. Carter Neal. Levi Smith. Marion County, Sohail Bhagat. River Bolyard. Christian Floyd. Shelby Hamilton. Cameron Harley. Putnam County. Owen Krimmel. Bryce Hill. Miranda Rainey. Taylor White. Roane County, Andrea Anderson. Brock Tanner. Tyson Watson. Wayne County, Trevor Hylton. Savannah Maynard. Donald Duke Parsley III. Alexander Ringkamp. Wirt County, Clayton Mills. Allison Neff.
Ladies and gentlemen, a great big round of applause for our newly inducted Golden Horseshoe winners. Another special component of this ceremony is the awarding of honorary Golden Horseshoe recipients. The recipients of these awards are exemplary educators or community members who have made outstanding contributions to West Virginia. Honorary Golden Horseshoes are given annually to individuals who have achieved one of the following: produced at least 10 winners of the Golden Horseshoe Award, taught West Virginia studies for at least 20 years, or made other significant contributions to West Virginia or the Golden Horseshoe program. In 2020, two outstanding individuals were selected for the honor, and in 2021, one individual was selected. This morning in the 9 a.m. ceremony, we will recognize our 2021 honoree. As I read a summary of the honoree's contributions, I would like the individual to come forward for the induction and the pinning. 2021 honorary Golden Horseshoe recipient, Brian Casto. Mr. Casto was nominated by Cabell County School Superintendent Ryan Sachs. Mr. Casto is an eighth grade West Virginia studies teacher at Milton Middle School and was just recently announced as Cabell County's Teacher of the Year. Mr. Casto has spent countless hours developing a video series known as West Virginia History in 2 minutes or less on YouTube. And I do encourage you to check that out. Share it with everyone because they're absolutely phenomenal. This series has over 40 videos cataloged on his social media platforms. Mr. Casto and his wife, Lacey, are proud parents of three sons, Jace, Madden, and Rhett. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Brian Casto. Mr. Casto is joined today with his wife and Milton Middle School principal, Kurt Mann. Another round of applause for Mr. Casto. We would like to thank all of our special guests with us today, and a special thank you to the West Virginia Culture Center staff for hosting us here today. The honor you received today places you in a very elite group of men and women who are knowledgeable about our state. I'm certain your achievements bring a great deal of personal pride, and I know a great deal of pride for your families, your teachers, and your school. Once our recipients have exited, parents and other guests may exit to your right using the closest exit. We do appreciate you being with us here today. At this time, please stand and remain standing to honor our Golden Horseshoe recipients as they proceed up the aisle. We would like to remind you that the West Virginia State Museum is open downstairs, and you are welcome to visit at your leisure. There's also a bottle of water available for everyone in the Great Hall near the library entrance. Again, we thank you for being here today. We do hope that you enjoy your visit here in Charleston, West Virginia, and we do hope that you have safe travels home. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. You are welcome to exit to your right now. Any of the doors.